with me this morning from Greatland Gold, I'm joined by Gervaise Heddle. Gervaise, good morning.
Good morning, Andrew.
Look, these results here this morning from Havieron got to be some of the best that we've seen, and tomorrow, quite timely, marks that it's the one-year anniversary since you signed that farm-in.
Yeah, no, that's right. Look, they're really great results, and it is, tomorrow it's exactly 1 year since we signed the farm-in, and it's been, you know, amazing the progress that's been made in that time. First we've had, six consecutive sets of excellent results. We've nearly completed stage two of the farming agreement already. We're at a point where, people are really thinking about, well, how do we potentially mine this?
Mm.
And Newcrest is investigating, high-grade stoping operations versus bulk underground operations. They're looking at the potential to put in a decline by the end of this year or early next year. So it really is just amazing in terms of the progress that's been made in such a short period of time.
And as far as some of the numbers, 83 metres at 5 grams, 82 at 6.1. Look, you've got to be happy with those.
Oh, yeah, they're exceptional numbers. I mean, just exceptional. What I love about that had 44 in particular is 83 metres at 5 grams per tonne plus 1.1% copper. I mean, just 83 metres at 1.1% copper would be, a fascinating, result. But then to throw 5 grams on top of it, and you basically go 83 metres at nearly 7 grams per tonne gold equivalent. And similarly, in had 49, you've got 82 metres again at, well over 6.5 grams per tonne gold equivalent, but approaching 7. I mean, they're just, fabulous results and give you lots of opportunity, whether you're looking at, high-grade stoping operations or bulk underground operations. Those are the sort of numbers that make those considerations possible. But look, I think probably, what people haven't necessarily looked at is just another couple of holes. So one in particular, had 42. Now, if you look at had 42, the headline number is 124 metres at 3.9 grams per tonne. But if you look at where that intersection is, that's in the breccia zone that's outside the high-grade zone. So what you've seen there is an intercept that's technically not in the high-grade zone, yet within that interval, you've got 17.3 metres at 19 grams per tonne gold. So that, is clearly very high-grade interval outside of where we thought the high-grade zone was. And interestingly, I was listening to a conference call with Mike Nossel, who's the outgoing Chief Development Officer at Newcrest, earlier today. It was hosted by RMARC, and he was saying that potentially this represents a new type of mineralisation in the breccia. So, I'm not sure if that's the case yet, but it's really fascinating. There could be, another type of mineralisation evolving which carries high grades. Mm. And it just speaks to the size and the complexity, of this deposit. And, again, I should just say what a great job, Newcrest have done in terms of getting on with it in such a rapid manner, less than a year, and dealing with the size of this and the geological complexity of it. But that's a fascinating result there in had 44. Had 42. The other interesting hole is had 45, where you've got 151 metres at 0.6 grams per tonne. Now, that's not headline grabbing, but that intersection sits outside the area that we previously thought was the breccia mineralised zone.
Hmm.
So you're seeing all this other brecciated material out there. So, potentially significantly expanding that zone. And again, that enables, perhaps more options for bulk underground mining. It certainly gives you more flexibility as you're looking at that.
So what are Newcrest up to on the ground at the moment? They've got 8 rigs turning, have they?
Yeah, so they've got 8 rigs turning. They've got 90-person camp. I mean, they really just, those 8 rigs are 24/7. I mean, they're just pushing forward as hard as they can. In the background, obviously, doing a lot of work on the studies and on permitting, because, look, if we're going to try and put in a decline by the end of this year, early next year, that requires a lot of permits to be done. So, there's a lot of work, going on in terms of drilling underground, but also behind the scenes, big team of people in the planning and studying, the various options for mining and declines, etc.
Mm. And they'd like to see a resource on this by the second half or in the second half of the year.
Yeah, well, I think, we're saying in the second half of the year, so previously we were saying by the end of the year, but look, there's no doubt that Newcrest wants to push this as quickly as possible. The sooner we have a resource, the sooner that can trigger other key activities, such as a lot of the pre-feasibility work. It's obviously a key part of stage three. And basically, the sooner you can actually get towards mine planning and ultimately, you know, towards the commencement of commercial production. But, you know, really trying to bring that forward because, look, Headline, you know, the issue is that Telfer only has a few years left of high-grade ore from the underground. So, you know, there's a very clear sense of urgency here, you know, on the part of both parties to get this done as quickly as possible.
But what we're seeing here at Havieron, as far as the geology, there's some similar traits here to your other projects in the Paterson.
Yes, well, certainly in the geophysics, the geophysical and geochemical signature at Havieron, you know, we've seen similar signatures at some of the other targets. And, you know, as we said in our interim report that we released on Monday this week, we will be, you know, really pushing forward with the drill targeting of those targets. We really spent last year working up those targets, and this year is about drilling them. And so we're going to be kicking off first with an airborne electromagnetic survey, but then really this year is about drill testing those targets, and first off the bat of the targets at Scallywag, which we hope to be drilling by late April.
And what do you make of the gold price at the moment and how that's moved?
Well, look, I think the gold price has been behaving as you would expect in this type of market environment, you know, which is, you know, an environment of fear because of the coronavirus and now economic uncertainty because, you know, entire countries have almost been put on lockdown. You know, I still think there's a lot of upside in the gold price. You know, fundamentally, you know, interest rates have been at zero for so long. There's been so much, you know, such a large expansion of the monetary base, you know, over the past 10 years, and that's only accelerated again. You know, I think the underlying environment for the gold price is very strong. You know, so it's, you know, one of the great things about our business is that, you know, our commodity is at five-year highs, and really there's very little to suggest in my mind that, you know, you'll see any retracement in that, other, unlike some of the other commodities, which are obviously doing it very tough with the what looks like a significant economic contraction that's occurring globally.
Good to speak, Gervaise. Thanks very much.
Yeah, thank you very much, Andrew.